everyone, it's James.
And Stephanie, and hello from Quail Creek State Park in southern Utah.
That's right, we're down here in the RV. The weather has been fantastic, today we're talking boats.
Yep, and you can see we've got two boats that we've been traveling with the past couple months. I've got a paddleboard, because I love paddleboarding. James is in the kayak.
Yep. Now these are inflatables, as Steph said, and they're from Sea Eagle Boats.
Yeah.
And the reason we like Sea Eagle Boats for these inflatables particularly is because that's kind of all they do. That's
right.
Their thing.
Yeah, that's all they sell is inflatables. So if you're in the market for an inflatable, who are you going to go to?
Right.
Somebody who specializes?
It's not an afterthought for these guys at all. It's their main deal.
Yeah, and we need an inflatable because we travel in a camper van, and for us it'd be rigid kayaks would be so hard to deal with. We already got four bikes in there.
So, yeah. So having something that is not 13 feet long or whatever is definitely a plus when we're rolling the way we do.
Yeah, and we went with the one kayak, one paddleboard because we like both, but if we had two kayaks and two paddleboards,
well, that's a bit
too many toys in one camper van. So anyway, we got one of each.
Okay, now something you guys should keep in mind is that we are coming at this from the perspective of leisure boaters.
Oh yes, we don't race these things. We don't do overnight pack in, pack out, any kind of hardcore kayaking.
We are not hardcore. We are coming at this from the perspective of fun.
Yep.
So if you want to consider this a review of how much fun you can have with the boats.
Absolutely.
Speaking of fun, let's go into show and tell mode
right
now. And we're going to start with this boat that I affectionately call mine.
Well, yes, you ride it more, you can have it.
So this is a Sea Eagle 393RL RazorLite. So it's a kayak, obviously, but of all the inflatable kayaks I saw, this one to me looked the most like a regular boat,
hard
boat.
Yeah, absolutely. I love how when I'm riding this, my feet aren't covered up. I feel like I'm more out in the open. I'm not in the enclosed.
So you don't like sticking your legs in the hole.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. There's no hole. Well, there's a little bit of a bow cover there.
But that's okay. I feel that's all right.
But the reason this looks so much like a boat is because we can inflate it to a really high pressure.
10 PSI.
10 PSI. And this one, and it's because they've got a drop stitch technology in the walls and in the bottom of it. And so it keeps it very rigid, hence we're able to get a rigid form that looks like a boat.
Yeah, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm squeezing that and it's hard to even indent it. It's so rigid.
Yeah. Let's see, a couple little things about the boat really quick. So we've got some drain valves here. If you get a bunch of water in the boat,
yeah,
I would never do that. I would never get water in the boat. It's like sand. Anyway, there's an adjustable seat. This is very adjustable. It just hooks in quickly with four rings.
It's very comfortable, and it's also got a little pack for your stuff.
It's not a dry bag, but it is a pack.
Yeah.
An adjustable footrest and the inflation valves up front. And this morning I inflated this with just a hand pump.
Yeah.
There is a mechanical battery powered inflator.
Yep.
But I didn't use that. I didn't with a hand pump. It took me like 10 minutes tops.
Yeah, that's
right?
Fantastic. The bow and the stern do have more hard, rigid.
That's right. There are rigid inserts on the bow and stern that helps it cut through the water.
Yeah.
There's a removable skeg in the back, which helps it track straight. Speaking of us not being professional kayakers, I'm reminded of that horrifying experience, Peter, Kathy, where we were in a kayak that was a more advanced kayak, and I could not get it to go straight for the life of me.
Yes, it was quite an experience. We were spinning around going down a river and eventually just gave up and floated our way down the river.
Nothing like that's going to happen in this. This thing tracks amazingly well.
Oh,
I can paddle.
Oh, and it's so fast. One of the reasons it's so fast is that concave hull on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
So they've made it so it's more, I don't know, is it aerodynamic? So there's less drag in the water on the back.
I don't know what they did, but I like paddling it.
It's just a really fun boat to ride in.
All right, so that is mine, the 393RL. Now let's show you Steph's.
All right, so this is the paddleboard we've been using. It's the HB96.
Well, it's mostly you that's been using it, let's be honest.
James isn't as thrilled about paddleboarding as I am, but you've been on it.
If you can imagine a cat on a paddleboard, like... that's
But I want to tell you some great things that I love about this paddleboard. First off, it's 32 inches width, so that's pretty wide. I like to do paddleboard yoga, and I feel a lot more stable with the extra width. The model is HB96, and that's because it's 9 feet 6 inches in length, and that's pretty short.
How clever.
For a paddleboard. And my main goals for a paddleboard are stability and portability. And so when you're talking about, shorter, it's going to be a lot more portable. It's going to pack down, and I love this one.
But portable, the carry handle, this is something I can appreciate. The carry handle in this thing is fantastic.
Well, there's actually three carry handles. There's two on the ends for convenience. But the main one, you're going to carry this all on your own using the middle handle. Mm-hmm. So that's one of the great things about it. Another cool thing about this one is the paddle storage. Can you hand me that paddle?
There you go, ma'am.
I want to show you guys this. This is, I love this. So there's a little pocket here. You just tuck the paddle into, and it goes under bungee cords, and just like that, you can just carry it away.
Grab the handle, off you go.
Yeah, you got it all in one hand. You still have a free hand. Is that brilliant?
Now, as the cat on the paddleboard, I really appreciate this grippy texture that they've put on here.
Yeah.
It helps me, you know, I'm not the best at a paddleboard, but this helps me feel a lot more stable. Also, that little lip on the back.
It's like some sort of like kick.
It's to prevent you from accidentally walking off the back end of the boat.
And that's handy, especially when you're doing yoga on a board, when you're sticking your leg back there so you can find that and know your placement.
One also tracks pretty straight. I mean,
we've got
three fins on the bottom. We've got two smaller ones and one larger removable skag on the bottom of the boat.
Yeah, and like I said, stability is a big deal for me, especially since I'm doing yoga out there. And I feel so stable. This is just a really fun paddleboard. I can steer it well, too. I think the front nose has a slight upturn, too, so when it takes waves better and surf. I try to avoid waves and surf. That's not my kind of paddleboarding. But when I have to take it, this one handles it really well.
Yeah.
As far as D-rings, look at all these D-rings it's got on it. Here's four right here. Now, these four, you could even attach the optional seat. So you might like that better if we got the optional inflatable seat.
I wonder if my seat would fit on it.
I don't know. We could try it sometime. But I like that idea. I think that would be fun to try. I haven't tried that. There's some more D-rings up front. You can see these cords. You can stick your gear. There's so many places for gear on this, so I would think you overnighters might find
really
that handy.
You pretty much do just about anything.
Now, as far as inflating, this one's so much easier to inflate because it's only got one chamber compared to the kayak. The kayak has three chambers. It still only takes like a minute longer.
This one goes up to like 15 PSI, so this gets a little more pressure in this one than in the kayak.
Yes.
And you can tell when you get on the boat. It's not like standing on a noodle. This thing is nice and firm.
And Sea Eagle is using that same drop stitching that they use on the kayak here on this paddleboard, and that's why they can get it so rigid and firm. And it really does feel like a rigid paddleboard.
All right, so you've seen the boats, you know the people, you see the lake.
And now I think it's time for some fun.
Agreed. Let's get out of here and have some fun. This is James.
And Stephanie.
See you later. Bye.